you enroll to take classes at a local community college. There is a $50 registration fee, and then every credit hour costs an additional $85. Write a linear equation and a linear function to represent the total cost to take classes for the semester. Make a table of values using the linear function, then graph the linear function. Before we write the linear equation and the linear function, we need to define the variables to represent the unknowns. And we have two unknowns. One unknown is the number of credit hours, and the second unknown is the total cost. For the linear equation, let's let x equal the number of credit hours and y equal the total cost. Because this relationship represents a function, meaning every input has exactly one output, or in this case, for the number of credit hours taken, there's exactly one total cost, we can also represent this relationship using a function. For the function, we will let x equal the number of credit hours, and we'll let the output, or the total cost, equal the function value, c of x. So again, we will let x equal the number of credit hours, and we'll let y equal c of x, which equals the total cost. To write the linear equation, we'll use the variables x and y. To write the linear function, we'll use the variable x and the function value, c of x. For the linear equation, the total cost y equals the registration fee of $50 plus $85 per credit hour, which would be 85 times x, or 85x. However, it is more common to write a linear equation in the form y equals mx plus b, meaning we normally write the x term before the constant term. Let's also write this equation as y equals 85x plus 50. And now again, because this relationship represents a function, we can replace the output variable y with the function value c of x. The linear function is c of x equals 50 plus 85x, or c of x equals 85x plus 50. Next, we will make a table of values using the linear function c of x equals 85x plus 50. To do this, we select input values or x values and then find the corresponding function values. Each row in the table represents an ordered pair, where each ordered pair represents a point on the graph of the linear function. And because most classes are 3 credit hours, notice I decided to use x values. We will use x equals 0, 3, 6, 9, and 12. When x equals 0, the corresponding function value is c of 0. To determine c of 0, we substitute 0 for x, which gives us 85 times 0 plus 50, which equals 0 plus 50, which equals 50. This gives us the ordered pair 0, 50. Next we have x equals 3. The corresponding function value is c of 3. C of 3 equals 85 times 3 plus 50. 85 times 3 equals 255. 255 plus 50 equals 305. The next ordered pair is 3, 305. Next is x equals 6. The corresponding function value is c of 6. C of 6 equals 85 times 6 plus 50. 85 times 6 equals 510. 510 plus 50 equals 560. The next ordered pair is 6, 560. Next we have x equals 9. The corresponding function value is c of 9. C of 9 equals 85 times 9 plus 50. 85 times 9 equals 765. 765 plus 50 equals 815. This gives us the ordered pair 9, 815. And finally we have x equals 12. The corresponding function value is c of 12. C of 12 equals 85 times 12 plus 50. 85 times 12 equals 1,020. 1,020 plus 50 equals 1,070. This gives us the ordered pair 12, 1,070. I do want to emphasize we did not have to select these x values to complete a table of values. We can use any x value that we want, though we should recognize that x would never be negative, and typically x would have to be a whole number. And now to graph the linear function, We'll plot each point represented by these ordered pairs. Looking at the coordinate plane, notice how we have the number of credit hours along the horizontal axis, and we have the cost in dollars along the vertical axis. The first ordered pair is 0, 50. To plot this point, starting at the origin, we go up 50 units to this point here. This point is also the vertical intercept or y-intercept of the graph. The next ordered pair is 3, 305. From the origin, we move right 3 units, up 305 units. This is another point on the graph of the line. The next ordered pair is 6, 560. So from the origin, right 6, up 560. The next ordered pair is 9, 815. From the origin, right 9, up 815 units. And finally, we have the ordered pair 12, 1070. From the origin, right 12, up 1070. Notice how the 5 points do form a line. The graph of the linear function passes through these 5 points and forms this line here. Now that we have the graph of the linear function, I do want to highlight some important things about linear functions. Looking back at the linear function c of x equals 85x plus 50, notice how the 85, which is the coefficient of x, represents the increase in cost per credit hour, which is the constant rate of change of the linear function, or the slope of the linear function. And then this 50 represents the initial cost, or in this case, the registration fee. Looking at the graph, notice how this represents the vertical intercept or y-intercept of the graph. And then finally, the set of all possible inputs for the linear function is called the domain of the linear function. In this case, it's more likely that the domain is a set of all non-negative integers or the set of whole numbers, not all non-negative real numbers, as indicated by the graph of the line. However, it is typical to show this type of information using the graph of a line, as we see here. I hope you found this helpful.